beautiful morning will bring a smile on your face and happiness in your life. So, a very good morning to all my students. Pleasure in the job puts perfection in the work. No work is small or big. It is the man who can make it as big as he wants. No work is big or small if you do it with honesty and hard work. So, the name of the today's chapter is Dignity of Labor. One day, Sujata saw her maid Shanti crying while working in the kitchen. Sujata asked her why she was crying. The maid said that her one-year-old daughter was suffering from high fever. She had left her at home and was worried about her. Sujata had tears in her eyes. She told her mother about Shanti's problem. Her mother immediately asked her to go home and look after her daughter. Then Sujata's mother herself started washing the dishes. She also cleaned the house. Sujata helped her mother in completing the work. Sujata's mother was very happy to see Sujata working with her. She said, "No work should be considered dirty or low. All kinds of work must be considered respectfully. We should appreciate work and people doing that work. This respect given to all kinds of work is known as dignity of labor." Many people help us to keep our neighborhood clean and green. Let us meet the people who help Sujata and her family keep their neighborhood clean and green. Manya is a sweeper. He cleans the gutters and drains. He sweeps roads of the colony. He sprays insecticides during the rainy season to kill mosquitoes. He is always cheerful. He is not educated, but he sends his son to school. He wants him to become a government officer. Charya goes from house to house to collect household garbage. He then throws it into a big garbage box placed at the end of the road. He sends his daughter Rita to school. He wants Rita to become a doctor. Kashiram is a gardener. He looks after Sujata's garden. He waters the plant. He removes dry leaves and weeds. He worked hard throughout his life to give his son a good education. Today, his son is an engineer. He still works because he loves and enjoys his job. Sujata's grandfather said that we must give respect to all these helpers. They help us to keep our surrounding clean and healthy. Sujata's father has a lot of respect for Manya, Jharia and Kashiram. He treats these helpers as his equals. Really, Sujata's grandfather and father are right. Every human being should be treated with respect. If they did something wrong, never shout on them because they didn't mean to do it. You should tell them it's okay. They are doing a job and deserve respect. When they bring you food or do some work for you, say a pleasant thanks. Imagine what would happen if these helpers do not come to work for a couple of days. Every human being should be treated equally according to their human rights. Human rights is the belief that everybody should be treated equally and with dignity no matter what their circumstances. which means nobody should be tortured or treated in an inhuman or degrading way. In India, before independence, low caste people were made to do menial jobs like sweeping the floor and cleaning the toilets. High caste people ill-treated them. Low caste people were considered as untouchables. So, they were forced to live outside the village and town. They were also not allowed to use the wells that were used by high caste people and pray in temples made for high caste people. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of nation, fought against untouchability. He named untouchables as Harijans. Harijans means the people of God. Gandhiji also worked for the upliftment of Harijans. To help them develop self-respect and self-confidence, he often visited their colonies and spent a lot of his time with them. Gandhiji believed in the dignity of labor and he honored and respected all occupations. Fortunately, untouchability has been abolished in our country. It is now a punishable offense. We must be kind to all. We must treat the people who work for us as our equals. We must respect all occupations. So children, read the chapter carefully. Today I am giving you one activity, that is, you have to imagine what would happen if these helpers do not come to work for a couple of days. Discuss the situation with your parents and write only 5 lines about this situation. Thank you and have a nice day.